as a co-host talking about female boxing as much as we did on this show, still had to work during the week at her parents' Mexican restaurant. How fucking ridiculous. That was true, and it was stupid.
That could be true, but I'm telling you, there's still somewhat of a market for them, at least traveling the world, getting to fight everywhere, things like this. There's your give and takes. Yes, everyone wants to make $1 million. I understand that.
You don't want to make $1 million?
No, yes, I do.
Are you just happy with what you have? And
no, sir.
Working
every
in
day.
Your little square and not looking every at bigger I'm houses?
Nope, every day I try.
Damn right.
That's right.
Damn right, until you actually find out how much work it is to make $1 million. And I'm not putting past anything to these athletes. They've given up, I'll say this, they've given up their motherfucking lives to not eat chili, to not eat pizza every night like you fat slobs
right.
who listen to this
have
show.
Fun.
Yeah, they don't have
go
fun.
To parties.
They go to bed early.
Right?
They train. And if
most of the time when these guys were kids, they didn't go over their families or friends' houses to have spend the night. Eat your birthday cake at 2 in the morning again, dude. Their dads would whoop their ass.
Whoop.
Let them miss weight. Let them
I mean,
miss
that
weight,
never
dude.
Goes sideways, right? Michael Jackson isn't fucked up
I
from
know.
That shit at all, right?
Oh, there's a million kids are. But the ones that make it usually do have that strong two-parent household, too. Most of the time. Most of the time, people. Not all the time. But most of the time, yeah, it's a two-parent household that also gets, you know, the best out of these kids.
I agree. I literally agree. So what's going on with you? Anything you want to share on the show?
Nope.
You're not going to talk about your return to the ring after a 20-year layoff?
Yeah, right. No, sir.
All right, everybody. I hope that amused you for at least an hour of your commute or your drive. For those of you that listen to the show, for the internet community who listens to this show, you guys are a bunch of fucking wackadoodles.
I don't like night shows. Sorry, people. I like to do the show in the morning. Please.
I don't know. I seem to be a little more perkier than you do at night than I am in the morning. But I will say this. We appreciate all of you. We did put the show together a little late. I did come back from Vegas. It's my fault.
And then I'm on call. I'm on call right now, Lee, so I like constantly staring at my phone, making sure no one called me for emergency. The hospital is down. Water's leaking everywhere. I fucking hate those calls. Like, shit.
It is what it is. What did you barbecue?
I got a call this weekend.
No, more importantly, what did you barbecue? Call. What was on the smoker? Or did you barbecue?
Steaks? No, I had steaks. I had hamburgers. What else did we have?
Her family, your family.
And chicken. Christina's.
Ah.
Yeah.
They don't think I'm a drug addict yet, so we'll have to... Next time I come up, we'll have to make that happen.
12:35. Got a phone call. We have a bad elevator. We need you. I said, sir, I don't do elevators. AC and refrigeration. He goes, you guys are taking over our account. You better come. I said, sir, I got to make a phone call, but I know we don't do elevators. I leave. Like, I didn't know what to
Would you even
guy.
Know what to do with an elevator?
Oh, hell no. We don't do elevators.
Dude, I got on an elevator. Okay, so I stayed at the D this weekend, right? Because there were, like, 5 concerts in town. The town was a mess. So I wound up, because of Derek Stevens and the D Hotel and going to all those fights. You know, I'm a D guy, right? So it's the first time that I've been there with these fucking wackadoodle pre-programmed elevators. Like, you literally walk to a wall and type in your floor number.
Yeah.
It assigns you to an elevator shaft.
A letter? Did it give
yes.
you a letter?
Yes. Holy shit. That's either the greatest thing or the scariest thing ever, because there's nothing on the walls. And if this shit doesn't work, what do I do inside? Like, I feel like there need to be controls on the wall for me. Like, I'm on a spaceship that I'm not in control of when that thing starts to go.
The buildings in SF now, Lee, they like to save energy. So on certain times of the day, they'll only have one elevator running now.
Smart. Smart.
So, yeah. So you'll sit in a lobby that has 4, maybe even 6. Yet let's only run 1 or 2 because we want to save
energy. Kind of smart. Kind of smart. It is what it is. It would have been funny to hear you trying to fix an elevator and not knowing how to fix an elevator.
I called him back. I hung up on that guy. I called my boss. He's like, dude, no, we don't. You know we don't. And I was like, I know that. He's like, well, call them back. called them back, and they're like, yeah, he's just a little wound up right now. Sorry about that. Wrong number. I was like, come on, you guys. Killing me. Killing me.
Wow.
Oh, it's Santa Rosa, too, people. If you don't know, that's about 125 miles away from my house. Did not want to drive up there for an elevator.
Absolutely not. There was boxing on this afternoon. You got the kids playing. You got the house. You got to show off the concrete run. Did the concrete run got done, right?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Did everybody come out and look at the concrete run?
Yes.
They did, didn't they?
That sucks. That's when all you got to look forward to when you're a homeowner.
Dude, oh, that's all there is. What did you do this weekend?
Look at my new door I built.
Goddamn right. I had a house like that once. I currently don't have a house like that, and I'm happy to say that everything's done on this place, and there's a gardener who does everything else. But
that's my next move.
It's got to happen, bro.
Yeah.
Got to happen. Let me tell you the joy of watching your gardener sweat his balls off and cleaning up shit in the backyard.
No, I don't need him full time. I just need a one time gardener. I need the backyard leveled, and that's about it.
You gonna drop fake grass or real grass?
Real.
I want fake grass. I want to pull out all of my fucking grass and put fake grass. I have really nice green grass. Everybody else in my neighborhood is a bunch of fucking liberal tree fucking huggers. Right, so everybody's grass is brown, or they pulled out their lawns and put in sand or something.
Fucking
right?
Cactus.
Yeah, whatever. Fucked up. My grass fucking glows, okay?
Sprinklers on while
Sprinklers
it rains.
Sprinklers are on during the day. I make sure they come on when they're leaving to their fucking jobs in their suits.
Hey, you know what, Lee? We had a few of those guys in our neighborhood, right? When the drought, I know people will get off right now. This is bonus. So we have a few. You have a few of these guys in the neighborhood, right? It's fucking, everyone's like, it's a drought, we're dying, there's no water.
It's California. Wait, but for everybody to understand, Andrew and I are in California where the cost of water is more expensive than gasoline in our state. Like, that's not even a remote joke.
And then who had the last laugh in this last winter when we got more water than ever?
Oh, so great.
Right? Here we are.
So great. I watched every single one of their yards go right out onto the street. I watched all that sand and all that bark and all that shit float right down into the gutter. And everybody just had piles of dirt out in front of their yard. Laughed my asses off. I laughed every day. I'd walk around. I wasn't even a big fan of walking. I wanted to walk around just to look at everybody's yard who lost shit from their front. Like, I have a neighbor who's got one of those, like, sculpture. Like, they got sand and everything just drifted right out of the front yard and right down. Fucking made me laugh. Laugh my motherfucking ass off. I'm going to go water my grass some more.
Go water my grass.
In front of you people with a hose. Slowly. And I'm going to do it old school East LA style.
You really want to piss off a tree hugger.
Wait, East LA style, Andrew. I'm going to get an aluminum lawn chair and sit out there and just put the hose on the grass and run.
And if you really want to piss them off, people, if you really want to, wash the driveway. Wash the driveway. Death threats. They will come out with death threats.
So great. I never thought about that one.
Right?
I am the guy who's always at war with all the neighbors, right? I'm the guy who's like, I'm him. I'm the guy who's always fucking with everybody else. I admit it. I'm him. You don't want me in your neighborhood. But here's the problem. I have the same money you do. I just work a lot less and I'm home during the day. And so I'm kind of a dick. They all wave at me and they all scowl. They all hate me. They hate me, Andrew. They hate me around here. Like, they're waiting. They want me to.
I started power washing my driveway and I was like, there's no way I'm going to do my whole driveway. This is bullshit.
Bro, that's
Lee, how do they
hardcore.
Do it?
Hardcore. That's hardcore. Like, I stopped washing my car because I even thought that that was a blatant wash. Like I didn't want to wash my car. That's such a tree-hugging area. Like, I bring in a crew to wash all of our cars. I don't even know how they do it with as little water as they do it. Like, there's barely any water on the street. I'm like, how do you fucking do that? Like, how's that work? Cars are spotless. Fuck it. It is what it is. That's some bonus shit for you guys. I hope
you
enjoyed
it.
Just understand that Andrew and I are fucking with our neighbors just because it amuses us. There you go. FightNetRadio.com. Again, I'll say it one last time. Get a ticket. go to Ticketmaster. I'll even look it up right now, right? It's Ticketmaster.com. You're going to type in probably Lomachenko if you can spell it. Yeah, sure is right there. August 5th, 4 o'clock. Lomachenko. Tickets are as little as... You can get tickets for as little as $29 motherfucking dollars, Andrew. $29.
Well, it should. He's 8-1.
Hey, and you're getting a free drink from me. You can't even buy a drink in downtown L.A. for $29. So you guys get a deal. You get boxing, and you get to hang out with me. Until I find you boring, and I go back over to the really cool seats behind the stage while you sit up in the fucking mezzanine and really can't see from that far away. But hey, I don't want to be a dick about it. I'm just telling you how it is. The most expensive seats are actually $107. Like, that's the most expensive seat in the building to sit in the loge. Just calling it as it is. They're going to bring the... they're literally bringing the ring, it looks like, all the way out into either the stage or the pitch. It's a theater, Andrew, so they're going to do that staging thing. I'm sure it'll be fine for this. I'm sure they didn't pay that much for this, so it'll all work out. I will see all of you at that fight. Follow me on social media at lee-honish on either Facebook or Twitter, and you'll see updates and photos of me. So if you're coming to the fight, just really, literally walk towards the orchestra area at the front. You will be okay. I'll actually cruise around once or twice during the show. I'll come up to the loge in the mezzanine. If you are a Fight Net Radio fan, just hit me on social media. Really, how hard is it? Go onto Twitter. Type in Lee Honish. There's only one of us. And I can't believe that I actually have to say that all the time. So who's this Lee Honish guy? That's me. There's only one of us. Fuck. People kill me. And I will, I'll come up. I'll come up to the mezzanine. I'll come up to the loge. I'll buy you a drink. I've done it all the other fights. I do it at almost every event that I'm at. We usually have a couple of fans who always track me down. Yes, there are times when I'm being shitty and I don't want to be found. I admit that. I have been known to do that because I am involved in other things. But this is not one of those moments. I will be readily accessible to all our fans. So follow us at fightnetradio.com, social media on Facebook at fightnetradio, or you can follow both Andrew Lapache, use a P, or at Lee Honish, both of us. We're both on Facebook. I'm on Twitter. You can find us. Follow us. Have fun with it. Internet boxing community. Everybody calm down about this fucking McGregor-Mayweather thing, please. Fuck, got a month to go. Pace yourselves, please. I will get Bobby Cappucci on this week for you guys. We can start talking about why he thinks what he thinks. And we will be back next week with more boxing and fighting related news for all of you out there. Thanks for listening.
Thank you for enduring another episode of Fight Net Radio. FightNet Radio is available for download and subscription on iTunes. Or visit FightNet Radio and tell us how offended you are by today's show. Thank you for listening.